A 28-year-old male comes to the office for management of a broken jaw. This is a bad injury, but there's an even more serious injury he's not yet aware of. The full workup and treatment today on the Open Reduction. Welcome to the Open Reduction, your channel covering all topics oral and maxillofacial surgery. I'm Dr. Tom Bolten, and today we're talking about an interesting case involving a mandible fracture and an additional injury that's easy to miss but can have life-threatening implications. This patient is a 28-year-old male who was referred to my office for management of a mandible fracture. He was wrestling with his friend when he was slammed to the ground, striking his chin hard on the floor. The impact caused a 2-centimeter laceration in his chin and intense pain in his jaw. After the injury, he was unable to open his mouth or eat anything. He initially went to the emergency room, where his chin laceration was repaired and a CT was obtained. The CT scan showed a fracture in the right condylar head of his mandible. This fracture is non-displaced and the condyle is still sitting in the fossa. This hospital did not have OMFS on staff, so he was discharged with instructions to follow up with an oral surgeon. He then came to my office. I had no way of reviewing the entire scan because I'm not on staff at the hospital that he went to, but he did provide this picture, which clearly demonstrates the fracture. I was also provided the radiology report, which noted an isolated fracture in the right condylar head of his mandible. I perform a thorough clinical exam, and he's able to recreate his natural occlusion with no interferences. There is no segment mobility and no ecchymosis anywhere else. Okay, so we have a 28-year-old male with pictures from a hospital CT scan, a radiology report, and a clinical exam that all points to a non-displaced fracture of the right condylar head. The question is this sufficient to treat this patient? I wish I could do a live Q&A to see who would treat this patient and who wouldn't. Sadly, I can't do that, but I can give you my answer, which is a hard no. This is not sufficient. This patient is my full responsibility the second I decide to treat him, and part of that responsibility is reviewing the entire scan to make sure that nothing is missed. I always read radiology reports, and I have great admiration for radiologists. However, I think Reagan said it best, trust but verify. I obtained a cone beam CT in my office, chiefly because I want to make sure there are no additional fractures anywhere else in his mandible. There could easily be a fracture in his left condylar head as well, and he may even have a fracture in the symphysis or parasymphysis given the mechanism of his injury. I scrolled through the images, and thankfully the rest of his mandible is intact. But there is a very important finding that I discovered. Here's his image, see if you can spot it. Right here, this is it. This is a fracture in the base of his skull, otherwise known as a basilar skull fracture. This fracture is uncommon, but it makes perfect sense given the nature of his injury. When his chin hit the ground at a high velocity, his condylar head was violently impacted into the fossa, which is part of the base of the skull. The impact caused both bones to break. This is concerning because a basilar skull fracture can lead to intracranial bleeding and cerebrospinal fluid leak, both of which can lead to death. I instructed him to go back to the ER, and sure enough, he had hemotympanum, or blood pooling behind the tympanic membrane of the ear. This is a clinical telltale sign of a basilar skull fracture in the temporal bone. Thankfully, there was no CSF leak, and there was no intracranial bleed. He was treated with prophylactic antibiotics, and the minor bleeding in his ear stopped after a few days. I treated this patient with MMF screws and wired him shut for only 2 weeks because it was a mild non-displaced fracture. He then adhered to a no-chew diet for 4 weeks, and at 6 weeks he was able to resume his normal diet and activity, minus the wrestling. Everything healed well and he made a full recovery. Thanks so much for watching. Please click those like and subscribe buttons, and check out my channel for additional interesting OMFS cases just like this one. Also, keep an eye on my website, theopenreduction.com, coming soon. I'm Dr. Tom Bolton. I'll catch you next time on The Open Reduction.